Mabuhay and magandang umaga po. My name is Moki Hino and I am the priest in charge here at Good Shepherd Episcopal Church in Wailuku, Maui, where today we are celebrating the feast of Gregorio Aglipay, the founder of the Iglesia Filipina Independiente. For this very special service this morning, we would like to say thank you, first of all, to our musicians, Ferdinand Cahigal and Carissa Cahigal, our very special acolytes this morning, Mr. Alfredo Evangelista and Senator Gil Keith Agaron. Also, our readers are Jordan Akana, and our intercessor is. And as always, we would like to thank our technology team for making these virtual services possible. I should also mention that we have a very special video presentation for you this morning from Ilocos Norte. And we also have very special dancers this morning. So with that, let's begin with the ringing of the bell.
Thank you.
Blessed be God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
And blessed be his kingdom, now and forever. Amen.
Almighty God, to you all hearts are open, all desires known, and from you no secrets are hid. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name through Christ our Lord. Amen. Glory to God in the highest, and peace to his people on earth. Lord God, heavenly King, almighty God and Father, we worship you, we give you thanks, we praise you for your glory. Lord Jesus Christ, only Son of the Father, Lord God, Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world. Have mercy on us. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Receive our prayer. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Eternal God, you called Gregorio Aglipay to witness your truth in the renewal of your church in the Philippines. Help us, like him, to be guided by your Holy Spirit, that people everywhere may hear the saving words of our Savior, so that all may believe and find eternal life through the same Jesus Christ, who with you and the Holy Spirit lives and reigns, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
And now we will have the reading of the lessons.
A first reading from the Book of Chronicles. David said, "All this, in writing at the Lord's direction, the Lord made clear to me, the plan of all the works." David said further to his son Solomon, "Be strong and of good courage, and act. Do not be afraid or dismayed, for the Lord God, my God, is with you. He will not fail you or forsake you, until all the work for the service of the house of the Lord is finished. Here are the divisions of the priests and the Levites for all the service of the house of God. And with you in all the work will be every volunteer who has skill for any kind of service. Also the officers and all the people will be wholly at your command." King David said to the whole assembly, "My son Solomon, whom alone God has chosen, is young and inexperienced, and the work is great. For the temple will not be for mortals, but for the Lord God. So I have provided for the house of my God, so far as I was able, the gold for the things of gold, the silver for the things of silver, and the bronze for the things of bronze, the iron for the things of iron, and wood for the things of wood, besides great quantities of onyx and stones for setting, antimony, colored stones, all sorts of precious stones, and marble in abundance." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Psalm 126. When the Lord restored the fortunes of Zion, then were we like those who dream. Then was our mouth filled with laughter, and our tongue with shouts of joy. Then they said among the nations, "The Lord has done great things for them. The Lord has done great things for us, and we are glad indeed. Restore our fortunes, O Lord, like the watercourses of the Negev. Those who sowed with tears will reap with songs of joy. Those who go out weeping, carrying the seed, will come again with joy, shouldering their sheaves."
The second reading. The end of all things is near, therefore be serious and discipline yourselves for the sake of your prayers. Above all, maintain constant love for one another, for love covers a multitude of sins. Be hospitable to one another without complaining. Like good stewards of the manifold grace of God, serve one another with whatever gift each of you has received. Whoever speaks must do so as one speaking the very words of God. Whoever serves must do so with the strength that God supplies, so that God may be glorified in all things through Jesus Christ. To him belong the glory and the power, forever and ever. Amen.
The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord Christ.
Jesus said, "The kingdom of heaven is like a landowner who went out early in the morning to hire laborers for his vineyard. After agreeing with the laborers for the usual daily wage, he sent them into his vineyard. When he went out about 9 o'clock, he saw others standing idle in the marketplace, and he said to them, 'You also go into the vineyard, and I will pay you whatever is right.' So they went. When he went out again about noon and about 3 o'clock, he did the same. And about 5 o'clock, he went out and found others standing around, and he said to them, 'Why are you standing here idle all day?' But they said to him, 'Because no one has hired us.' And he said to them, 'You also go into the vineyard.' Now when evening came, the owner of the vineyard said to his manager, 'Call the laborers and give them their pay, beginning with the last and then going to the first.' When those hired about 5 o'clock came, each of them received the usual daily wage. Now when the first came, they thought they would receive more, but each of them also received the usual daily wage. And when they received it, they grumbled against the landowner, saying, 'These last worked only 1 hour, and you have made them equal to us who have borne the burden of the day and the scorching heat. But he replied to one of them, Friend, I'm doing you no wrong. Didn't you agree with me for the usual daily wage? Take what belongs to you and go. I choose to give to this last the same as I give to you. Am I not allowed to do what I choose with what belongs to me? Or are you envious because I'm generous? So the last will be first, and the first will be last. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
The Diocese of Batac traces its beginning to 1902 as part of the Diocese of Ilocos Norte, with Pedro Brillantes as the first bishop. Upon his consecration in October 1, 1902, Bishop Brillantes declared Bacara Ilocos Norte as his seat. The Diocese of Ilocos Norte was given life in 1957. When the Supreme Council of Bishops divided Ilocos Norte into two dioceses, namely Diocese of Lawag and the Diocese of Ilocos Norte Second District. The Diocese of Ilocos Norte Second District became the Diocese of Batac that covers the 10 parishes and 2 mission churches in the southern part of the province. It is composed of 11 municipalities with a total population of 280,000 as per census in 2015. It is the home of the first Supreme Bishop, Monsignor Gregorio Aglipay, where his birthplace is in Batac, Ilocos Norte. The Cathedral of St. Mary in Batac City is also where the remains of Monsignor Aglipay laid to rest. It is also called as the Aglipay National Shrine. Ilocano is the dialect, and the majority can speak Tagalog and English. Our members are called Aglipayanos, with their attribution to Monsignor Aglipay, living out its nationalist heritage as a church. The diocese is set in an agricultural economy, and life is hard due to the lack of irrigation systems, inefficient systems of marketing agricultural products, and poor delivery of basic services by the government. Being resilient as a virtue, a significant number of the population are employed as overseas Filipino workers in greener pasture abroad. We also have a multitude of immigrants living in many parts of the United States and worldwide. The Diocese of Batac belongs to one of the top performing dioceses of the Iglesia Filipina Independiente. As the cradle of Aglipayanism, the diocese confronts the many challenges of doing ministry with other 3 factional groups that have splintered from the church membership throughout her history. It currently have in its rosters 38 licensed lay ministers, subdeacons, communion ministers, and lay readers, serving an estimated 70,000 faithfuls in 12 churches and 6 mission chapels. Amidst the pandemic, we strive to work in unison as a diocese, conducting regular diocesan council meetings, clergy meetings, and sectoral meetings of the YIFI, WUPIC, and the LIFI. For the year 2020, the vision of the Diocese of Batac, true to her legacy as the regional and authentic Aglipayans, envisions a dynamic, sustainable, and resilient local church whose faithful, the ordained, and the lay are united in living out our historical mission, holistically responding to various people's needs, carrying the slogan, Pro Deo et Patria, for God and country. It carries on with a mission, the Diocese of Batac to be consistent in doing her ministry as a nurturing and liberating community of faithful stewards, inspired by the Holy Spirit and committed to equip the clergy and the lay to incarnate the IFI mission and ministry in the world.
Good morning, everyone. I do have to say, we have had such a good time getting this service ready for all of you. And so I thank Gregorio Aglipay for providing us with that opportunity. You've seen a dance called the Alai. It's an offering dance. And so we use that in this morning's service to offer up the life and the legacy of Gregorio Aglipay to God. You've also seen a special video message from the Diocese of Batac, where my friend Emlyn Dakuikui is the bishop. She is the first female bishop consecrated in the Iglesia Filipina Independiente, of which Gregorio Aglipay is the founder. It really, having ordained women, having consecrated female bishops, I think this would be very much in alignment with Gregorio Aglipay's philosophy and theology and way of thinking. He was one who, like Jesus, spoke against the powers. The powers of his time were colonial Spain, who occupied the Philippines for about 300 years, and also the Roman Catholic Church, because they were an agent, basically, of the Spanish government. And Gregorio Aglipay, being a nationalist and advocating for his countrymen, said, "Hey, wait a minute, this isn't right. Our country shouldn't be controlled by somebody else, and our church should not be controlled by somebody else. Our church should reflect who we are as Filipinos." And you know, now in 2021, that includes women and women priests and women bishops. So I think that we should really bear in mind that we're called to have the fortitude of courage and the gift and the grace of stepping out in faith when we have convictions not only that we believe in, but that we feel obligated to state and to proclaim. And this is what this man has done. And I think that the heritage that he offers to this congregation is one of which we should be very proud of, bearing in mind that Good Shepherd has had women ordained in its sanctuary. The Reverend Mother Linda Decker was ordained here. Part of that is all due to courageous people who said, "No, you know, we've got to change the way things are." And so we're grateful. Also, because that philosophy incorporates all the body of Christ, like the gospel reading today incorporates all the body of Christ and says, you know, all are equally loved in God's sight. It for some reason reminded me of a song that I learned as a little boy. And there's a line in this song that says, "Ikaw saligayang nabuhay." Ikaw saligayang nabuhay. From what I understand, what that means is, through you, I have happiness of life. And I think that through Gregorio Aglipay, many people in the Philippines had happiness of life. So because of that line that I remembered and that stuck with me, we'd like to right now share with you the song Ikaw. And please remember, Ikaw saligayang sa buhay, because of you or through you we have happiness of life. And we say that not only to Gregorio Aglipay, we say that not only to one another, but we say that to Jesus Christ and to God. Now let's affirm our faith by reciting together the words of the Nicene Creed. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he became incarnate from the Virgin Mary and was made man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son. With the Father and the Son, he is worshiped and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. And now we will have the prayers of the people.
I ask your prayers for God's people throughout the world. We pray for the province of the Episcopal Church of Sudan. We pray for our retired clergy, the Reverend Charles and Shirley Cannon, the Reverend Canon Franklin and Norma Chun, the Reverend George and Susan Clifford, the Reverend John and Carol Connell, the Reverend Canon David and Joanne Kuhn. We also ask your prayers for Michael, our presiding bishop, Robert, our bishop, Moki, our priest, for this gathering and for all ministers and people. Pray for the church. I ask your prayers for Joseph, our president, David, our governor, and Mike, our mayor, for peace, for goodwill among nations, and for the well-being of all people. Pray for justice and peace. I ask your prayers for the poor, the sick, the hungry, the oppressed, and those in prison. Pray for those in any need or trouble. I ask your prayers for all who seek God or a deeper knowledge of him. Pray that they may find and be found by him. I ask your prayers for the departed. Pray for those who have died. Praise God for those in every generation in whom Christ has been honored, especially Catherine Zell, Gregorio Aglipay, Hannah Moore, Kassian, Ellie Nod, Soren Kierkegaard, Nikolai Grundtvig, Constance and her companions, Alexander Crummel, and Harry Thacker Braley. Pray that we may have grace to glorify Christ in our own day.
Heavenly Father, you have promised to hear what we ask in the name of your Son. Accept and fulfill our petitions, we pray, not as we ask in our ignorance nor as we deserve in our sinfulness, but as you know and love us in your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
Thank you.
Let us confess our sins against God and our neighbor. Most merciful God, we confess that we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We are truly sorry, and we humbly repent. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us and forgive us, that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways, to the glory of your name. Amen. Almighty God, have mercy on you, forgive you all your sins through our Lord Jesus Christ, strengthen you in all goodness, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep you in eternal life. Amen. And now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. And the peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God, and of God's Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, and the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, be upon you and remain with you this day and always. Amen.
Oh.
Go in peace to love and serve the Lord. Agyamantai kuma iti Diyos.
Agyamantai kuma iti Apo Diyos.
Agyamantai kuma iti Diyos.
Agyamantai kuma iti Apo.
Agyamantai.
Agyamantai.
Kuma.
Kuma.
Iti.
Iti.
Diyos.
Diyos.
Agyamantai kuma iti Diyos.
Yamantay kuma iti Diyos.